بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والعاقبة للمتقين، ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين. وأصلي وأسلم على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، وبعد. سورة قاف وهي مكية. إن شاء الله today we're gonna start the tafsir of the Quran. We're going to be using the tafsir of Imam Ibn Kathir rahimahullah ta'ala. We're going to start from Surah Qaf. The reason is because Surah Qaf is the awwalul hizb al-mufassal in the Quran. What does that mean? Al-hizb al-mufassal. Aus, who's one of the great companions from the great tabi'in, who's from one of the great tabi'in, he said, سألت, I asked أصحاب رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. I asked the companions of the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم. He asked them what? كيف يحزبون القرآن? How they used to, how they divided the Quran. That's what he asked them. How they divided the Quran. The companions, they said to him, they said, three, ثلاث, وخمسين, five, وسبعين, seven, وتسعين, nine, وإحدى عشر, 11, وثلاثة عشر, and 13. وحزب المفصل. And after that, the حزب, which is the مفصل, is what? Is وحدة by itself. So they divide, they took the Quran in three surahs, five surahs, seven surahs, nine surahs, 11 surahs, and then 13 surahs, and then only Surah Qaf was left by itself. And this is the is narrated by Ibn Majah on the authority of Abi Bakr. Abi Bakr Ibn Abi Shayba also narrated it. Also Abi Khalid Al-Ahmar and Imam Ahmad Ibn Hanbal, Abdurrahman Ibn Mahdi, and other than them narrated this. Other than them, they narrated it. So if we look at it, how is it going to be? How is the details? The details is as follows. Surah Al-Baqarah, Surah Al-Imran and Surah Al-Nisa'i are three. Ma'idah and An'am and A'raf and Anfal and Surah Al-Tawbah are five. You see? So seven is what? Yunus, Hud, Yusuf, Ra'd, Ibrahim, Hijr and Nahl. There are seven. Nine is what? Isra, Kaf, Maryam, Taha, Anbiya, Hajj, Wal-Mu'minun, Nur, Furqan. Those are the nine. The 11 are what? Shu'ara, wal-naml, wal-qasas, wal-ankabut, wal-rum, wal-luqman, wa-suru al-sajda, wal-ahzab, wal-saba, wa-fatir, wa-yasin. The 13 is Safat, Saad, Zumr, Ghafir. Hamim sajda. Wa-hamim ayn sinqaf. Zukhruf. Wa-dukhan. Wa-jathiyya. Wa-ahqaf. Wa-al-qital. Surah Muhammad. Wa-al-fatah. إِنَّا فَتَحْنَا الْحُجُرَاتِ. You see, when we say حُجُرَات, that's the 13. Now what starts from there? The juz, that's the حزب, that's مفصل, it starts from there, which is Surah Qaf. Surah Qaf. See, so ثُمَّ بَعْدَ ذَلِكَ الْحِزْبُ المفصل, as the Sahabas used to do it. So the strongest view is that, and the chosen view is that the juz, the حزب المفصل is Qaf. And because of that is why we chose to make Surah Qaf the tafsir to start from. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he used to read Surah Qaf in Eid and he used to read it in the khutbah. Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal narrated. He said, حدثنا عبد الرحمن بن مهدي حدثنا مالك عن ضمرة بن سعيد عن عبيد الله بن عبد الله أن عمر بن الخطاب سأل أبا واقد الليثي. أبو عمر بن الخطاب he asked أبا واقد الليثي, the companion. He said, ما كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقرأ في العيد. What did the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم used to read in what? The صلاة العيد. He said, بقاف, سورة قاف, واقتربت الساعة. سورة اقتربت, سورة الساعة. That is narrated by Imam Ahmed. And I gave you the sanad of Imam Ahmed. And it's also narrated by Imam Muslim. And it's also narrated from the four a'immat sunnah. Four da'immat al-arba'ah. Sunan al-arba'ah, sorry. Abu Dawood, Tirmidhi, Ibn Majah, Nasa'i. Four of them. All of them, they narrated it from who? That's Habu Sunan, min Malik. The narration of Imam Malik, rahimahullah. As for the narration of Imam Muslim, it's an Falih and other than Malik. So he got it from Falih and Dumrata and Ubaidullah and Abi Waqid al-Layfi. Also, Ummu Hisham binti Haritha. Ummu Hisham binti Haritha, she said, as is narrated by Imam Ahmad, as is narrated by Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal. Imam Ahmad narrated it min riwayat Ishaq, that is narrated from Abdullah ibn Muhammad ibn Abi Bakr ibn Umar ibn Hazm and Yahya ibn Abdullah ibn Abdul Rahman ibn Sa'ad ibn Zurara and Ummu Hisham ibn Haritha. Also Muslim, the same narration, same sanad. From the same sanad, na'am. That she said, Ummu Hisham said, bint Haritha, that she said, لَقَدْ كَانَتْ تَنُورُنَا أَوَ تَنُورُ وَتَنُورُ رَسُولُ وَتَنُورُ النَّبِي صلى الله عليه وسلم, that the fire that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم used to light and our fire وَاحِدٌ they were one. That the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, تَنُور is meant by the fire when it's lit on the oven. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is Nur, fire, and our fire was one. What does she mean by that? Mean we were neighbors. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and us were neighbors. For how long? Wahid was sittina. Wahid was sittin, 61 or sana, or 1 year wa ba'du sana, other than a year. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and us were neighbors. 61 months, or a year and a half, or some of the year. وَمَا أَخَذْتُ قَافٍ, and I never took qaf. والقرآن المجيد, I never took it from nowhere else, إلا على رسول الله, except from the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم. وَكَانَ يُقْرِئُهَا, the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, he used to read كل يوم الجمعة. The Prophet used to read qaf every Friday. Where? على المنبر, on the pulpit. إذا خطب, whenever he done khutbah, عليه الصلاة والسلام. This hadith is narrated by Imam Ahmad, and it's also narrated by Imam Muslim. All both of them, min hadith Ibn Ishaq. Min hadith Ibn Ishaq, Muslim narrated in his kitab al-Jum'ah, bab al-takhfif al-salati wal-khutbah, the bab of takhfif al-salati wal-khutbah that Imam al-Nawwi done for the tabu, for the bab. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to read Surah Al-Qaf on the pulpit, and he used to read it also on Eid. Sahih? Hafiz ibn Kathir rahimahullah said, wal-qasad, what was the intent in why the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to read it? What was the intent? وَالْقَصَدُ, the intent is, أَنَّ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ, the intent is that the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم used to read Surah Al-Qaf. The intent. Why the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم used to read Surah Al-Qaf on the pulpit is, أَنَّ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ كَانْ يُقْرَأْ بِهَذِي السُورَةِ فِي الْمَجَامِعِ, he used to read it in the places of the gathering, where the people came together. كَالْعِيدِ, on the Eid days. وَالْجُمَعِ, and on the Jum'as. Why? This is the reason. لِشْتِمَالِهَا, because it consists of it, عَلَى ابْتِدَاءِ الْخَلْقِ, the starting of the creation. وَالْبَعْثِ وَالنُّشُورِ, and the death, the people dying and being resurrected. It consists of that. And وَالْمِعَادِ وَالْقِيَامِ وَالْحِسَابِ, and going back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and being put on accountability. وَالْجَنَّةِ وَالنَّارِ, and the jannah and the hellfire. وَالثَّوَابِ, and the rewards. And وَالْعِقَابِ وَالتَّرْغِيبِ وَالتَّرْهِيبِ. All of this is what the surah consists of. All of this is what the surah consists of and contains. So because of that, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what did he used to do? He used to read the surah on the pulpit alayhi salatu wa salam, and in the gatherings of where the people were. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. In the name of Allah, the most merciful, the most gracious. Allah says, Qaf wal Qur'an al-Majid. بَلْ عَجِبُوا أَنْ جَاءَهُمْ مُنذِرٌ مِّنْهُمْ فَقَالَ الْكَافِرُونَ هَذَا شَيْءٌ عَجِيبٌ أَإِذَا مِتْنَا وَكُنَّا تُرَابًا ذَلِكَ رَجْعٌ بَعِيدٌ قَدْ عَلِمْنَا مَا تَنْقُصُ الْأَرْضُ مِنْهُمْ وَعِنْدَنَا كِتَابٌ حَفِيظٌ بَلْ كَذَّبُوا بِالْحَقِّ لَمَّا جَاءَهُمْ فَهُمْ فِي أَمْرٍ مَرِيجٍ قَاف الله أعلم بمراده. Allah knows what he intends from this meaning word. قَاف. قَاف is from the word كلمات. The حروف, sorry. They are from the letters that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he took with him the meaning. And it's referred to as, the scholars and Mufassirin used to say, حُرُوفٌ مُقَطَّعَ. They are the letters that are disconnected, the letters that are cut up. They are what? They start with 29 surahs and they are 14 letters. They are 14 letters and they start with 29 surahs in the Quran. The first surah it starts with is Suratul Baqarah, and the last surah it finishes with is Suratul Qalam. 29 surahs in the Quran. The meaning of it, we will take the path of what the four Khulafa al-Rashideen took. Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman, Ali, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. We will take the path in which they took, which is what? هِيَ مِمَّا اسْتَأْثَرَ اللَّهُ بِعِلْمِهِ. It is from the things in that which Allah is alone in its meaning. No one else knows. The Quran, the ayat that are mutashabiha, the ayat that its meaning are not known, the scholars they divide into two. Mutashabih mutlaq and mutashabih nisbi. Mutashabih mutlaq and mutashabih nisbi. Mutashabih mutlaq is what? Mutashabih mutlaq is what? It's an ayah in which its meaning is not known, or a kalima in which its meaning are not known whatsoever. Only Allah knows it. That is called mutashabih mutlaq. There's another one which is mutashabih nisbi. Its meaning is known, but with some people they don't know what the meaning is. The meaning to some people is not clear. It is mutashabih, it's unknown. Its meaning is not clear to some people. That's called mutashabih nisbi. Amma mutashabih mutlaq, it is like these huruf, which are huruf muqatta'a. Qaf, noon, alif lam mim, alif lam ra. These are huruf mutashabih mutlaq. The meaning in totality is not known. This is the call of the Khulafa al-Rashideen al-Arba'ah, and the call of who? Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. There are some scholars who gave the meaning to it. There are. But this is the qawl which is the strongest. Now, what is the wisdom behind it? We gave the meaning. We said Allah knows the meaning. And we explain that. هِيَ مِمَّا اسْتَأْثَرَتْ ثُوَهُيَ مِمَّا اسْتَأْثَرَ اللَّهُ بِعِلْمِهَا. It is from those things Allah is singular in its meaning. Allah is alone in what is meant by it. That's what the meaning is. We explain that. What's the wisdom and why it's been started with? The wisdom has been explained. Hafidh ibn Kathir rahimahullah, Hafidh ibn Kathir, in tafsir of Surah Al-Baqarah, he brings that the wisdom in why it was started or it's been mentioned, he says that it is bayanan, it is to clarify, li'ijazi al-Qur'ani, it is to clarify the weakness and the unableness of the human being in bringing something equivalent to this Qur'an. Allah is starting Qaf with the Qur'an. It's to show the Arabs, look at this Qur'an which you're reading. It's letters in which you will know. You know the Arabic alphabets. It's known. It's like Qaf. Known. Alif Lam Mim. And even then you guys are not able to bring anything like it or equivalent to it. So it's to give them ijaz, to make them weak and unable to come with something like it. This is the qawl of Ibn Kathir rahimahullah. And he said also this is the qawl of Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah. And also the qawl of Abu al-Hajjaj al-Mizzi, al-Imam al-Mizzi, who are both the shuyukhs, the teachers of who? Hafidh Ibn Kathir. They are both the teachers of Hafidh Ibn Kathir rahimahullah. Qaf, Allah knows what is meant by it. Allah alone knows what is meant by it. Wal-Qur'ani. And the Qur'an, that is what? Majid. The Qur'an, that is wal-Qur'an. Qaf, Allah knows what is meant by it. Wal-Qur'ani, by the Qur'an. The waw is waw al-qasam. Wallahi, the waw you use there is the waw that is used here. Wal-Qur'ani, Allah is swearing by the Qur'an. Al-Majidi, that is glorious. The Qur'an, that is glorious. The scholars, they say, there is a qasam, there's a wallahi. Okay? Where is the answer to the qasam? Where is the answer to the oath? Where is the answer to this vow that Allah is given? Allah swore, he said, wal Qur'ani ish al-majid. So when I swear, I say, wallahi, hey, what's the answer to the wallahi? I will give you £10. So the answer, I will give you the £10, is the answer to the qasam, sahih? So where is the answer to this qasam? The ulama, they say, it revolves around three. The jawab al-qasam is mahdoof here. It's mahdoof, it's hidden. What are they? Three qawls. Three qawls of the mufassirin. The first one is, we say, وَالْقُرْآنِ, we swear by the Qur'an, هَا الْمَجِيدِ, that is glorious, لَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا مُحَمَّدٍ, we send down Muhammad. It's what? What's the answer to the qasam? Meaning, the answer is, لَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا, we send down مُحَمَّدٍ, we send Muhammad. That's the answer, one goal. The second goal is, which is the second goal for that, what the jawab al-qasam is, والقرآن المجيد ما آمنت قريش. The second one is, by the Quran, by the glorious Quran, I swear, Allah is saying, hey, ما آمنت قريش, Quraysh did not believe. Quraysh did not believe. That's the second one. The third call is, والقرآن, by the glorious Quran, والقرآن المجيد, by the glorious Quran, لا تبعثن, you will be resurrected. لا تبعثن, you will be resurrected. That's the three جواب القسم which is محذوف in this ayah. بل عجيبوا, they became بل nay, they wonder. Allah is saying بل عجيبوا, they wonder. أن جاءهم, that there has come to them, min an ja'ahum, min an ja'ahum, that there has come to them, hey, mundirun ayuna, meaning Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They are what? Wonder. They wonder. An ja'ahum, min an ja'ahum, that it has come to them, ayuna, minhum, that wuna that is from amongst them, is like them, human being like them. فَقَالَ الْكَافِرُونَ, then the disbelievers, so the disbelievers said what? هَذَا, where is that ismu ishara gonna go to? The question is, هَذَا is the ismu ishara. When I say هَذَا بَيْتٌ, I have to say هَذَا, that's here. What goes with it? بَيْتٌ is a house. So this ishara has to go something. The ulama, they say the fasirin, هَذَا this كَوْنَ مُحَمَّدٍ مُنْدِرًا, meaning Muhammad bin Awuna, هذا, meaning this, Muhammad bin Awuna, شَيْءٌ عَجِيبٌ, it is something that is fascinating. It's a strange thing. It's something our minds cannot comprehend. It's a wonder, fascination, that this person who is amongst us has now stood up and said to us, he is a Awuna from Allah. شَيْءٌ عَجِيبٌ, that is what? شَيْءٌ, something that is عجيب. Allah says in Surah Yunus, telling us that this is nothing to be wondered about. Allah said, أَكَانَ لِلنَّاسِ, is it for the people? عَجَبًا, fascination. And أَوْحَيْنَا, that we have sent revelation, إِلَى رَجُلٍ, to a man, مِنْهُمْ, from them, and أَنْذِرِ النَّاسَ, to warn the people, go warn the people. Is that something one, do they find fascination and wonder in that? Ibn Kathir rahimahullah says, وَلَيْسَ هَذَا بِعَجِيبٍ, that's not wonder. فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ يَصْطَفِي مِنَ الْمَلَائِكَةِ رُسُلًا مِنَ النَّاسِ, because Allah chooses from the angels whoever He wants, as Allah chooses from the creation whoever He wishes. So it's nothing to wonder about. It's nothing to be fascinated about. This is what Allah does, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He chooses. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said after that, أَإِذَا مِتْنَا, if we die. The alif in أَإِذَا is alif istifhamiya. It stands, the alif here stands up, stands for what? هَل. The ulama, they say, أَإِذَا مِتْنَا, the alif al-istifhamiyah here, there's a fi'l al-mudari' al-mahzuf. There's a fi'l al-mudari' which is hidden. Which is what? Anurja'u, will we be brought back? Idha mitna, if we die. Anurja'u, the fi'l al-mudari' which is mahzuf is here. Anurja'u, will we be brought back? Idha mitna, if we die. Wa kunna, and then we become. And we become what? Turaban. And we become what? Dust. Thalika, that. ذلك that رجع, it's a what? It's a far return. ذلك رجع بعيد, that is a return which is far. Some of you may ask yourself, so does that mean they believed it but it was far? No, they didn't. ذلك رجع بعيد means والمعنى أنهم يعتقدون استحالتي, that means they believed that it was impossible. وعدم إمكانه, and that it could never happen. So what did they mean by it when they said that is a far return? They meant that is a far from what, from reality. That is far return from reality. Meaning it's impossible for it to happen. far return from reality. It will never happen. We become dust. We become dust. Is it then possible that we will be brought back? Is that possible? That's what they said. أَنُرْجَعُ I said there's a fi'l mudari' which is what? There's a fi'l mudari' which is mahdoof. The alif is alif istifhamiyah. So we say أَنُرْجَعُ we will be brought back. The kalima you have to know, just out of benefits, inshallah, is very important that you know the fi'l nurja'u, this fi'l al-mudari', it comes from a mazdar. Two mazdar it comes from, which is the original source. It comes from a mazdar. It comes from raja'a. It comes from raja'a. If it comes from raja'a, then it's a fi'l mut'addi. Meaning it brings a maf'ul. It requires a maf'ul. But if it comes from the word ruju', if the mazdar is ruju', it then becomes mut'addi. It becomes lazim, sorry. It becomes lazim. If it's what? Ruju', the mazdar is ruju', it becomes what? It becomes lazim. But if it comes from the asl, the mazdar is raja'a, it becomes what? Raja'a Muhammadun ila al-bayti is fi'l. He come, Muhammad came back to the house, ila al-bayti is jumla qa'imatun fi mahalli maf'ul bih. So it needs a fi'l, it needs a what? It needs a maf'ulu bih. قَدْ عَلِمْنَا Allah says, قَدْ عَلِمْنَا We know, Allah is saying, مَا تَنْقُصُ الْأَرْضُ That which the earth takes in. مِنْهُمْ From their dead bodies. Allah is saying, قَدْ عَلِمْنَا We know, مَا تَنْقُصُ That which the earth is decreasing. That's the right way of translating the ayah. تَنْقُصُ comes from the word نَقْص, decrease. Which means taking. Allah is saying, we know. They are saying to us, are we going to... this ayah is explaining the ayah to come after, which is what? They're saying that if we become dust, are we going to be resurrected again? Is it possible that we're going to be resurrected? That's verily something far from reality. Allah is then saying to them, let alone me being able to bring you back and resurrect you. Rather, I know, Allah is saying, قَدْ عَلِمْنَا I am aware and I know. مَا تَنْقُصُ الْأَرْضُ That which the earth is taking minhum from their dead bodies. I even know the earth when it swallows their dirt and it eats it, Allah says, I know where exactly it is. وَعِنْدَنَا And Allah is saying, with us is what? كِتَابٌ A book. حَفِيظٌ That preserves things. A book that is preserved. حَفِيظٌ With us is a book that's preserved. Meaning everything to us is known. Everything to us is known. There's nothing that is not hidden from us. Al-Imam Ibn Kathir rahimahullah said, مَا تَأْكُلُ The earth does not eat مِنْ أَجْسَادِهِمْ From their body فِي الْبِلَى نَعْلَمُ ذَلِكَ Allah is saying that we know it. وَلَا يَخْفَى عَلَيْنَا And Allah is saying nothing becomes hidden from us. أَيْنَ تَفَرَّقَتَ الْأَبْدَانِ Where the body has become divided in the earth. وَأَيْنَ ذَهَبَتْ And where it went. وَإِلَى أَيْنَ صَارَتْ And what has it become? Allah said, all of that we're aware of. We're aware. So how can it be possible, if I am aware of all of that, that person can say that, how will Allah bring us back again, subhanahu wa ta'ala? Allah then said, بَلْ كَذَّبُوا Allah is now going to tell us, subhanahu wa ta'ala, as Ibn Kathir said, ثُمَّ بَيَّنَ تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى Allah makes it clear to us, سَبَبُ كُفْرِهِمْ Why they became disbelievers. وَعِنَادِهِمْ And why their hard-headedness occurred. وَاسْتِبْعَادِهِمْ مَا لَيْسَ بِبَعِيدٍ And they considered far reach what wasn't really a far reach. Something that can happen. They saw it to be impossible. Allah is going to tell us why. Why is it, brothers, that these people did not believe in all of these things? Look what Allah says. Because the ayat that has to become something we implement. And we understand. Allah is saying, بَلْ كَذَّبُوا They believed in it. They disbelieved in it, sorry. بَلْ كَذَّبُوا They disbelieved in it and they denied the Quran. The truth, bilhaq. The truth here is the Quran. Hey, lamma, when it came to them, they disbelieved it. For whom they are in what? They are fi amrin marij. They are in a state of confusion. They are in what? A state of confusion. Why have they become? Has it become hard for them to believe? Why did they become disbelievers? Why couldn't they take it in? Because when it came to them straight away, without looking, without pondering, they denied it straight away. As soon as it came to them, they refused the haq. This is why they became misguided. And this is why they became in a state of confusion. They couldn't distinguish between the right and the right and the wrong. Look what Ibn Kathir said, and this is a principle, it's a qa'idah jaleela. It's a forever living principle that we have to hold on to. What did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say in this ayah? بَلْ كَذَّبُوا When they disbelieved in the truth, and they didn't take it, they became what? In a state of what? Confusion. Ibn Kathir said on the translation of this ayah, he said, وَهَذَا And that, حَالُ It is the situation of what? كُلُّ مَنْ خَرَجَ عَنِ الْحَقِّ Everyone who leaves the truth, that is how his situation becomes. مَهْمَا قَالَ As much as he says, whatever he says, the person who leaves the truth behind him and doesn't take it in, however much he may speak, بَعْدَ ذَلِكَ After that, فَهُوَ بَاطِلٌ It is rejected. It is false. However much. It's the principle we have to know. That is why you see people who contradict themselves so much. Whenever they say something, whenever they do something, they're always wrong. Tomorrow they say something else. The next day they say something else. Every day there is a witch in Jadid. It's a new face. This is nothing except they left the haq. The haq doesn't have no contradiction. It's only one. So they are in what? Marij. Marij means what? Mukhtalif, mudarib, multabis. They're contradicted. They're in a state of lack of tranquility. That's why Allah said in Surah Al-Dhariyat, which will come to us inshallah, إِنَّكُمْ لَفِي قَوْلٍ مُخْتَلِفٍ You are in what? Speech that are مختلف. ما معنى مختلف? Different. Different. Every day you're on a new face. Allah then says, سبحانه وتعالى, أَفَلَمْ يَنْظُرُوا Did they not look? إِلَى السَّمَاءِ Did they not look at the سماء? فَوْقَهُمْ over them. كَيْفَ بَنَيْنَاهَا The way. Have they not looked? Allah is saying. سؤال استفهام إنكاري. Allah is saying to them, have they not looked? إلى السماء to the heavens which is above them فوقهم above them كيف the way بنيناها the way that we have made it وزيناها and we beautified it or we adorned it وما لها and it hasn't got in it فروج فروج is what? It's rifts meaning there's no cuts spaces in it فرج is There is no spaces in it. Allahu Akbar. Haven't they looked at it? Now Allah has given us a comparison to what? He's still answering their answer. They said, أَإِذَا مِتْنَا وَكُنَّا تُرَابًا ذَلِكَ رَجْعٌ بَعِيدٌ They don't believe that Allah can resurrect them again. Allah is saying to them, can you not see? I created what is bigger and I created what is stronger and I created what is in comparison to what you're saying, more harder. But to Allah, nothing is hard. As He said in another ayah, لَخَلْقُ السَّمَاوَاتِ The creation of the sky, the heavens, وَالْأَرْضِ and the earth, أَكْبَرُ is bigger مِنْ خَلْقِ النَّاسِ than creating the people. Allah said in another ayah, to create the samawat and to create the earth and the heavens is more bigger than create human being. So the one who did that is able to do this. Why would you not believe in it? Allah then says, وَزَيَّنَّاهَا And what did we do? We beautified it. وَمَا لَهَا مِنْ فُرُوجٍ Do you see any rifts in it? Do you see any places that are not leveled in the heavens? No, there isn't. And the earth beautified it, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And now what does he say about the earth? وَالْأَرْضَ And the earth. Allah then says, And the earth, مَدَدْنَاهَا We have spread it. We have what? We have spread it out. The ulama, they mention this is called Bab al-Ishtiqaq. Those of you who studied it, Babul Ishtiqaq. Ma ma'ana? The kalima to madannaha ishtiqaq before that goes before the wal ard. So you say, madadna wa madadna. We have what? Spread out. Al arda, the earth. Madadnaha, a spreading. That's what it means. Wal arda, the earth. Wa madadna. And we spread al arda, the earth. Madadnaha, a spreading. Wa alqayna. And we then set on them, on the earth, fiha rawasiya. Rawasiya means mountains. We made on top of it mountains. Wa anbatna. And we have then produced, Allah is saying subhanahu wa ta'ala, Where's the maf'ul? Because Allah says, wa anbatna, the fi'l is mentioned, and the fa'il is mentioned. The fi'l is nabata. The fa'il is Allah. Where's the maf'ul? What does Allah produce? Nabat. The maf'ul is mahdhuf, which is what? وَأَنْبَتْنَا We produce nabatan. We produce what? Nabat. We produce nabat. Fiha, on the earth. Min kulli. We produce every kind of it. Min kulli zawjin. Every type of growth. Bahij. Every type of what? Every type of growth was produced on the earth. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did. He produced it on the earth. As Allah said in Surah Al-Dhariyat, وَمِن كُلِّ شَيْءٍ, and on in everything, خَلَقْنَا, we created زَوْجَيْنِ pairs, لَعَلَّكُمْ, so you may تَذَكَّرُونَ, so you may think, wonder, ponder on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's creation. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, تَبْسِرَةً, Allah says, تَبْسِرَةً, that's a مَفْعُول, أي فَعَلْنَا ذَلِكَ, we did that, تَبْسِرَةً لِأَجْلِ تَبْسِرَةً, so why? Why did we do that? لِأَجْلِ تَبْسِرَةً, an insight. وَذِكْرَ, and a reminder. It's an insight, تَبْسِرَة. وَذِكْرَ, and a reminder. Reminder for what? لِكُلِّ عَبْدٍ, for every slave. عَبْدٍ, slave. مُنِيبٍ, that turns to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Every servant that is turning to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who's obedient, this is what for him? We did this, so he may take it as an insight and a reminder. وَنَزَّلْنَا, Allah then says, we sent down, مِنَ السَّمَاءِ, from the sky, مَا, and water. From the sky we sent down, هَيَّ, blessed. مَا, and water, مُبَارَكٍ, that is blessed. Water that is blessed. فَأَنْبَتْنَا بِهِ, and we then produced there within gardens, بِهِ, أي بِسَبَبِ الْمَاءِ, that بِهِ, that بَا, is بَاءُ السَّبَبِيَّ, بِسَبَبِ الْمَاءِ, the reason of the water, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what did He do? Jannat, in gardens. هَيَّ, وَحَبَّ الْحَصِيدِ, حَبَّ الْحَصِيدِ is grains. From them came, the rain came, what? Grains, meaning every kind of harvest. Then what does it mean? حَبْ means grain. حَصِيد means that were reaped. حَبْ الْحَصِيدِ, that were reaped. Some of you may ask yourself, the ulama, they say حب الحصيد is what it comes under باب حذف الموصوف وإقامة الصفة, that are reaped, meaning the grains. والنخلة, والنخلة, نخل is palm trees. باسقات, that have, باسقات means that is long. هي باسقات, لها, for it is what? For it is what? طلع النضيد, range clusters. Some of you may ask yourself, when the tree is at its first stages, that's not what it becomes. The ulama, they say that is حال المقدرة. This is what it's going to become. This is not at its first stages, but the one that has made it for it to become like that is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why has Allah done all of that? رزقاً, Allah has made it subhanahu wa ta'ala a provision. لِلْعِبَادِ, for who? For the servants. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it a provision for His slaves, subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَأَحْيَيْنَا, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, we gave life, بِهِ, بِسَبَبِ الْمَاءِ, through the water. Means through the water. بَلْدَةً مَيْتًا, a dead land. A dead land. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what did He say we gave it? Allah says we gave it life. Allah then says, subhanahu wa ta'ala, كَذَلِكَ الْخُرُوجِ, كَذَلِكَ خُرُوجِ, بِهِ بَلْدَةً, Allah says, we have أَحْيَيْنَا, we give life, بِهِ, بِسَبَبِ الْمَاءِ, because of the water, بَلْدَةً مَيْتَ, a land that is what? مَيْتَ, the description of that land is what? مَيْت, death, dead, it doesn't live. Allah then says, الْخُرُوجُ كَذَلِكَ, and what? The resurrection is like that. The resurrection is like that. We stop there. هذا وصلى الله وسلم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين. رب العالمين.